My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on data structures through C. This is lecture number 54. In this lecture, we will try to understand C program on merge sort. Hash include stdlib.h standard library header file, stdio.h standard input output header file, where we can find printf and the scanf functions. We will try to understand what is the intention of these two header files. This particular merge function, this is a merge function. It is, we already discussed this merge function in lecture number 52. I explained how to merge two sorted arrays. This is also similar function. I will discuss this function by taking simple numerical example. Then this is also part of that merge function. And this one is merge sort. What is the basic idea behind merge sort? This also I will discuss after few seconds. Before discussing these functions, all these functions I will explain. Before explaining these functions, let me take a numerical example. Let me explain. I already explained this particular slide in lecture number 54. Again, let me repeat that concept. Let me say this is the input. What is the input? 38 27 43 3 9 82 10. This must be the my output. 3 9 10 27 38 43 82 means this is not in sorted order. This is not in sorted order. This must be converted into sorted order. This is sorted order, isn't it? The elements are in increasing order. That is our intention. How one can do it? With the help of merge sort. This logic I already discussed in lecture number 53. Let me repeat it again. What is the basic concept behind this algorithm, this merge sort, divide and conquer technique, isn't it? Divide and conquer. Therefore, this list must be divided into two sublists. The same logic here. How can I this 38 27 43 3, this is sublist 1. This is another sublist, 9 82 10. How can I split this one? I will explain while explaining code, while writing code or while discussing the C program. Let me say this is divided into two sublists. Here again, this is number 1. After that, what you have to do? First step, that is first step in the program. Next step, just take this subarray or this sublist, just this indicate number 2. This is number 2. Again, what you have to do? You have to divide this into again two more sublists. As there are 4 numbers, I can divide into 2 sublists. This is second, this is third. Now I must take care about this third number. Just say order 3rd, 4th, 5th. Now what is this? You are getting 38 and 27. You must keep on dividing these numbers, these keys, till you get single number, isn't it? That's what it says, till you get single number. Just see, first this one, second, third, fourth. Now 38 and 27, fourth, fifth. After dividing 38 into 7, 38, two separate keys or two separate elements, I must merge these two numbers. But you must understand, while merging these two numbers, you must keep in sorted order. Just see, 27, 38. This is sixth one. What about seventh step? This sublist again divide into two sublists, 43, 3. Again, while merging, you must sort them. This is one sorted array. This is another sorted array. This must be merged. I already discussed in lecture number 52 how to merge two sorted arrays. This is sorted array, this is sorted array. This logic we already learned. In this manner, this also, just see, this must be divided. This is one sublist and this is another sublist. Again, single elements. Till you get single elements, you must repeat this process. Once if you get single element, just merge them. Just I am merging. While merging them, keep them in particular order. Again, this is one sublist, this is another sublist. Again, merge them. If I merge this one. Yeah, finally, what you have to do? You have to merge these two sublists. Again, apply merge. This is sorted list, this is sorted sublist. If you apply same logic, you will get this. This is sorted array. This is the input. This is the input. This is the output. How will it be? Let me explain this code piece by piece. This is the main function. If you go back and observe the code, you can see this. This is the main function, int main, which indicates beginning of your C program, int arr of square bracket. What is this? This we are initializing an array. How many elements are we keeping? Here we are keeping 7 elements. Just see, this 7 elements I kept in this particular array, isn't it? Next, int arr underscore size. Just see, int arr underscore size equal to size of arr. What is my size of arr? How many numbers are there? There are 7 numbers. Each number occupies 2 bytes, isn't it? 2 bytes, each integer number occupied 2 bytes. Therefore, there are 7 numbers. Totally, it needs, that array needs 14 bytes. Yeah, a size of arr of 0. Size of arr of 0 means 38 is an integer number whose size is 2 bytes. 14 by 2 means 7. What is the intention? This I already discussed while discussing quick sort or radix sort. I think in radix sort I discussed 14 by 2 means 7. This is useful for finding number of elements in this array. What does it mean? There are 7 elements in given array. That's what it says. Just see, this statement, we completed this particular statement. Given array is just before sorting, just we are printing the array. How can I print? Print array, we defined one function, that user defined function. What is that? Print array arr comma arr underscore size. This is arr, isn't it? This is arr. What is this? Is arr. And what is arr underscore size? Arr underscore size is 7. Therefore, through this print array function, we are passing array and its size. Automatically, control will go to this function definition. This into A, this arr is copied into A, and this arr underscore size, that is 7, is copied into size variable. Just we are displaying here I equals 0, 0 less than size, correct? What is my size? Size is 7, correct? Printf percent LD, A of I means, now this array name is A for me. A of 0 means 38, it will display. Again, I plus plus, your I becomes 1, 1 less than 7, it's correct. A of 1 means 27, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4, A of 5. Till it reaches 6, till it reaches I equals 6, 6 less than 7, correct. Till I reaches 6, it will print. Means it will print all the elements which ranges from 0 to 6. After displaying those numbers, print a backslash and means, after displaying numbers like this, 38, 27, 43, 3, 982, 10. Your cursor will go to the next line. That's what it says. Print a backslash and means, after displaying entered list, cursor will move to the next line. That's what this function says. Now I must start my journey. Let me start my journey. From where can I start my journey? This is the function merge sort. This is the function in which we implemented merge sort algorithm, through which we are passing array. Your array starts as array starts with 0. I am passing starting position, arr underscore size minus 1. Your arr underscore size is 7. 7 minus 1 means 6. Then what does it mean? We are passing array and its starting index and its ending index, isn't it? Is it not function call? Yes, this is function call. Just see, merge sort. This is function call. Just see. Merge sort through the, we are passing 0, arr underscore size minus 1 means, just know it is, this is 7, arr underscore size is 7, 7 minus 1, 6. As it is function call, automatically where will we go? We can go to the function definition. Let me check in next slide. We must enter inside the function definition. What it says, just see, this is definition of the function or function definition. L, that arr will copy to this arr. That 0, we pass it 0, arr underscore size minus 1 means this is 7 minus 1, 6. Now what I have to do? What is the logic? What it says, you have to divide this into two parts. Just see this diagram, this must be divided into two parts. How can I divide? Just see, this must be the logic. How can I divide? Logic is so simple and straightforward. What I have to do here, what is my L value? L value is 0. That's what I discussed. We paused 0 and RR underscore size minus 1, 7 minus 1, 6. Therefore, our R value is 6. If L less than R, you must always check whether L is less than R or not. Yes, 0 less than 6, yes. This is 0 index, this is 6 index. Now, what you have to do? You have to split this one into two parts. How can I split? I need middle. How can I find middle? There is a formula. This formula is in code. We have written here. M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. Just see M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. We know what is L. 0 plus R minus L. 6 minus G. 6 minus 6 minus L means what? 0. It's not 1. Yes. 6 minus 0. 6 minus 0 means what? 6. 6 by 2 means what? 3. This must be 3. Therefore, your M equal to 3. Now we have got, we know what is L. This is L. We know what is R. Yes, we know what is R. We know what is M. M equal to 3. Now you have to split into two parts. How can I split? Just say, merge sort of ARR L comma M. What does it mean? Just see, merge sort of ARR L comma. ARR means this array name. In that array, L means what? L means what? L is 0, L is 0, M is 3. Means we are considering array from 0 to 3. This part, 0 to 3. Means this is one part. Now, anyway, this I will discuss later. Just see. Now, I must keep on splitting this. Even if you observe our that slide, you can understand. Just see. You are keep on doing this one. Isn't it? First this one, this one, this one. Just the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This order only. We are following same order. Just check it out. Now I must take care of ARR, comma 0, comma 3. Isn't it? That's what it says. ARR L, comma M. Actually, what's happening here? Let me write otherwise like this. This is L. This is M. This is R. Now this is one sublist. And after M, certainly what will you have? M plus 1. Isn't it? This M plus 1 to R is another sublist. That's what it says. Just see. Merges after finding M. After finding M. Merges out of ARR L comma M. Just see. ARR L comma M. Then what is about other portion? ARR of M plus 1. Just see. M plus 1 comma R. M plus 1 comma R. Now, after doing left and right, I will get sorted. After doing that, what I have to do? I must merge them. For merging, I need ARR L comma M comma R. Anyway, I will explain this with sample program, with sample input, so that you can understand. Now, L is 0, M is 3. This is function call or calling function. Automatically control will go to the definition of the function. It will search for the definition. Anyway, the definition is void merge sort of ARR int L comma R. What is my L? Which one? ARR will copy to ARR. 0 will copy to L. This 3 will copy to R. Now L equal 0, R equal to 3. And this ARR as it is, it will copy to ARR only. We are not changing name. That's what it says. Just see, L equal 0, R equal 3. That what it says, this function, a function which calls itself. This function will call itself. From here, where will it go? It is recursive function call. Just see, a function which calls itself. A function which calls itself. Till which stage will it call? Till this condition fails. When this condition fails, if L equal to R. When L equal to R, you will get single element. If you keep on splitting, you must get like this. In this stage, function will fail. If that function fails, then what will it do? It will merge. While merging, it will keep in particular order. How will it be? I will analyze the code. Just understand this code. What it says, just see. L less than R, a function which calls itself. Just see. Now what is L? L equal 0, R equal 3. This particular function where we are, ARR is copied to ARR. L equal to, what is my L? L equal 0, R equal 3. Again, what it has to check? L less than R. That I explained in next next slide, this will keep on get executing. It will keep on executing. Just see L equal 0, R equal 3, L less than R, yes, 0 less than 3. In that case, what I have to do? If L less than R, my duty is I must find its middle point. M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. That's what I'm doing here. Just see M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. What is my L? L is 0, R minus, L means R, L means 0 by 2. 3 by 2 means it's 1.5, but it's an integer number. As it is an integer number, 1.5 cannot be, it will store only integers. Integer arithmetic always yields integer result, therefore M equal to 1. Now, after getting M, what I have to do? Just see. After getting M, what I have to, this is M. Again, this function, a function which calls itself merge sort of ARR L comma M. Just see, merge sort of ARR L comma M. What is my L here? My L is 0. What is my M here? 1. ARR of 0 comma 1. Again, this is function call. Again, this a function which same procedure it will repeat. Again, this function. Again, we are here. From here, where can I go? Again, same function. From here to here, isn't it? Same thing. That's what happening here. This, as it is function call, it will go to the definition of the function. Therefore, it will come here. Again, ARR will copy to ARR. 0 will copy to L. 1 is copy to R. L equal 0, R equal 1. Again, a condition will be checked inside. That one, if L less than R, it must check. 0 less than 1, correct. Then if L less than R, what is the condition? M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. Just see, M equal to L plus R minus L by 2. L means what? L means 0. R means what? Your R is 1 minus L means 0. 1 by 2 means 0.5. It can be integer arithmetic always, as it is integer arithmetic, it is 0 plus 0. M equal to 0. Then what happens now? Then what happens? Just we will try to understand. I have written in next slide. This after calculating M, again the function which calls itself merge sort of ARR of L comma M. Merge sort of ARR. What is my L? 0. What is my M? 0. Now again, as it is function call or calling function, automatically control will go to void merge sort and ARR will copy to ARR. Your L will copy to this 0 will copy to L. Your 0, this will copy to R. Again, inside void merge sort, I have shown this code in my previous slide. L equal 0, R equal 0. I must check if L less than R. L means 0, R means 0. 0 less than 0 means it's failed, isn't it? Which one is failed? This one is failed. If L less than R means this particular if block will be skipped means what happened? Just see. This is skipped. If L less than R condition is skipped, therefore you will come out of this one. This is if block, you will come out of this one. Again, a function. This we completed ARR L comma M. Now another function we have to see, that is ARR M plus 1 comma R. First portion ARR M plus 1 comma R means, just see this one. That's what it says. Just see ARR M plus 1. That left portion we did. Now, ARR of what is M plus 1? M means what? What is my M? We have shown M equals 0. 0 plus 1. What is my R? This R you should not take. This condition is failed means that in previous iteration, what is R? That R was 1. Therefore, int M plus 1 comma R means int ARR 1 comma 1. Again, merge sort call this. Again, it will, as it is function, a function which calls itself, again, it will go to L equal to 1 and R equal to 1. L equal to 1, R equal to 1. If L less than R, 1 less than 1. Means function fails. Means we have to keep on splitting the elements till you get single element. Means 0, 0, 1 and another one is 1, 1. What does it mean? After that, we already executed these two codes. Just see this one. We have executed these two function calls. Which two function calls? These two we completed, isn't it? This one is completed. This one is completed. Why? Because L less than R failed. For this one, 0 less than 0 failed. This, I think this is 1 less than 1 failed. Now, what is the, what we have now? Merge ARR L comma R. I will show you. Just see. Merge ARR L comma. This also I need not, I can proceed further. This is the stage. We are here, isn't it? ARR L comma, this is third one. We completed, there are two parts, isn't it? L comma M is one, ARR L comma M, and ARR
ARR M plus 1 comma R. These two we completed. Now, after completing, I have to merge them. How can I merge? There is function called merge ARR L comma M comma R. If you want, I will show you again. Just go back. This one, let me repeat it again. This one we completed. Which one we completed? Just see, this one we completed. And also this one we completed. Now we are checking this merging. Left portion, right portion, combining. Now this you have to execute. Anyway, that I will show. Just a few seconds, just wait few seconds so that you can understand things. This is merge. What it says, merge ARR L comma M comma R. L is 0, M is 0, R is 1. Now what I have to do? There is a function call. This is function call. It will go to void merge. This is just similar to a function which I discussed in lecture number 52. In lecture number 52, I discussed how to merge two sorted arrays, but just we added little bit extra code, I can say here. Little bit extra code. What is that little bit extra code? We will try to understand. And this 0 will copy to this L, and this 0 will copy to M, this 1 will copy to R. L equals 0, M equals 0, R equals 1. Now I need here N1 and N2. What is this N1 and N2? If you execute few iterations, you can understand. Here N1 is, just see, M minus L plus 1. This is N1. M minus L plus 1. What is my N2? N2 is R minus N. N2 is R minus N. I must take care about left portion, also right portion. This is about left subarray. This is about right subarray. From this one, I can calculate what is N1 and what is N2. I have LMR, everything I have. I have got N1 equal to 1, N2 equal to 1. Why? Because I will get one element in left sublist and another element in right sublist. This I can keep in left sublist. This I can keep in right sublist. This is single element. This is single element. That's what it will do. Yeah, what is your N1? N1 equal to 1, N2 equal to 1. Just what happens, I created two temporary arrays, L of 10 and R of 10 means internally two arrays will be created, L0 to N9, L9 and R0 to R9. Just I am copying the element, just see. I equal 0, I less than N1, what is N1? N1 is 1, ARR of L plus I, I0, L0, your ARR0 will copy to L0. I equal to I plus plus 1, 1 less than 1 false. Means this 38 I stored here in L array. Then again, after this one, where can I go? Z equals 0, 0 less than N2. What is my N2 value is 1. What it says, ARR of M plus 1 plus J. Why? Because this element I already copied. Now this element I must copy. M plus 1 plus J means, what is your M? 0. Plus J means what? 0. M means 0. J means 0. M, this is 1. ARR of 1. What is my ARR of 1? ARR of 1 is 27. Here this 27. This is R. 38 and 27 is separated. Just that's what it shows. In next slide, that's what it shows. Just see. That's what it shows. Just see. This L array is created. R array is created. I explained this code how it works. Just see, into L array I copied 38, into R array I copied to 27. Just go back to the slide. I will show. Let me go back. This one. Just see. Now where we are? We are here. We divided 38 and 27 separated. Now what is our duty? I have to merge these two. While merging, I must keep them in particular order, isn't it? That's what I will do here. Where can I do it? Yes, just see this one. Anyway, I equal 0, Z equal 0, K equal to L. What is my L in this case? 0. Therefore, I0, J0, K0. Now I am keeping this 38, which one? Yes. This 38, the 38 is first number in my given array, 27 is second number in I am keeping. This logic I already explained in my previous slide. Now what I have to do, these two things, why I must keep them into ARR. I must keep them into ARR. I already know what is ARR. While keeping them into ARR, I will sort them and I will keep them. First I will keep 27, then I will keep 38, isn't it? It is just similar to that slide I have shown. That's what I am doing here. Just see this code, I equal 0, j equal 0, k equal to l means I0, j0, k0. While I less than n1, j less than n2, I can say it is lecture number 52. It is simply lecture number. If L of I less than R of J, what I have to do? I am comparing this 27. Just a second. Let me erase all these things. I am comparing. Which one you are comparing? Just see L and R. This 38 and 27. If L is 38 less than 27, not. It's not true. Else you will go. And in that case, which one is, if it is not, it is false means 38 is. In that case, L less than R equal to L of I is less than R equal to R of J. Is it correct? L of 38 is less than, not true. Else, ARR of K. K means 0. ARR of 0 equal to R of J. What is my R of J? R of J means R of 0. 27. This 27 will get stored in ARR. This 27. That's what I am saying. Isn't it? Again, it will go back. I discussed. This is lecture number 52. Just merging of two sorted arrays. Nothing more than that. Just refer that lecture. You can understand. I need not repeat again and again. Yes. Now, what I did, just see. Earlier, it was something like 38 and 27. This we merged. We separated 27 and 38 is here. 27, we separated them and we merged this one. This portion is completed. Isn't it? I equal 0, J equal that code I explained here. Same thing. Just see. I imitated this code and I explained this code. Just you can explore this code. Just see I less than n1, j less than n2. Same thing. It will keep on executing for next iterations. You can. That's why I solved in piece of paper and I kept this all these things here. Just try to go through it. Now we completed. Which one we completed? This 27, 38 is completed. Now he's searching next one, 43 and 3. Means 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3. That if condition will fail. Therefore, again, this 2, 2, 3, 3 must be merged. Isn't it? Same logic. How will it be? Just see. The 27, 38 is L. This we already completed, isn't it? Now, just see. What about 43, 3, isn't it? 43, 3, next two numbers. Next logic is what you have to do? You have to merge them into ARR. Just see. Merge them into ARR. What's happening here? Just see. This is combined, separated. This is combined. If you want, just go back and I will show you. This must be the case. Let me show. Where can I show? Just go back. Oh, yes. This where we are, we are here. 27, 38 is one portion and 3 and 43 is another portion. That's what I did till this stage. I will repeat this process, 27, 38, isn't it? 27 and 38, 43, 3, this stage. In next stage, what happens? This I have shown again. This 27, 38, 343. I will repeat this same procedure. If I keep on repeating after some stage, just see 27, 38. If I keep on repeating 982, just this and this 982 while merging, I will keep in particular order. Just same code I am repeating. Same code, same procedure, same logic. If I keep on applying like this, you will get 982. Everything I wrote. After some stage, you will get a stage like this. Just see. This is the stage. This is left portion. This is last iteration, I can say. This is right portion. And this is one sorted array. This is another sorted array. I have to merge them into single sorted array. Just go back. Let me go back. Where am I? It is simply, just see this one. This is the case. This is one portion. This is another portion. This is in my last slide. I think I wrote paper number 20th paper. I have to apply which lecture? Lecture number 52. I must apply. We learned how to merge two sorted arrays. It is simple thing. Just observe every slide. That's why I solved like this on this paper. That's why I kept these papers. If someone is interested, how I wrote in this paper, just try to imitate. Once if you trace the code with these sample numbers, certainly you can understand real logic behind this program. But you must put little bit effort so that certainly you can understand. Thank you very much.